Stimulus Lighthouse Alert Neighborhood Presense, the mini-bio of Frederick Christ Trump Sr. Frederick Christ Trump Sr., better known as Fred Trump, was an American real estate designer and the father of the 45th President of the U.S., Donald Trump. He was born and raised in New York, United States. After his daddy's death, Fred Trump began a home construction business, in partnership with his mother. He was just 15 years old then. He began with structure vehicle garages and advanced to build apartment building. He developed barracks and homes near shipyards for United States Navy personnel, throughout World War II. He also constructed single-family apartment building for returning servicemen and middle-income group individuals. He built more than 27,000 apartment or condos around New York City. He was investigated for wartime profiteering from public contracts and was called in the past a United States Senate committee. He was a hardworking and enthusiastic man. Fred Trump and his company dealt with a racial discrimination fit filed by the Civil Rights Division of the United States Department of Justice for infraction of the Fair Housing Act. He was married to Mary Ann McLeod, and they had five children. He struggled with Alzheimer's disease during the later years and died at the age of 93. Childhood and early life. Fred Trump was born on October 11, 1905, in the Bronx, New York City. His parents, Elizabeth, née Christ, and Frederick Trump, were German Lutheran immigrants. His daddy was from Karlstadt, Germany, and was a barber who later on earned a small fortune in the Klondike Gold Rush. He passed away of influenza when Trump was 13. Trump was the second of the three children of his mom's and dad's. He matured with his senior sister, Elizabeth Trump Walters, and younger sibling, John George Trump. His middle name, Christ, was drawn from his mom's first name. Their household shifted to Woodhaven, Queens, after Fred's birth. He studied at the Richmond Hill High School. He was only 15 years of age when he established his own building and construction organization, in collaboration with his mother, Elizabeth, in the 1920s. He called the venture E. Trump and Son. As he was underage, his mother handled the official work till he was 21. Trump started by constructing garages for the recently invented and marketed cars. He discovered woodworking and studied how to read plans. He constructed his first home 2 years after finishing. Career: Trump had actually already finished 20 buildings in Queens by 1926. He constructed a supermarket, Trump Market, in Woodhaven, during the Great Depression of the 1930s. His market, which utilized the tagline "Serve yourself and save," became successful, and the next year, he sold it to the grocery store chain King Cullen. On Memorial Day in 1927, he was one of the seven individuals detained in Queens for refusing to disperse from a parade when bought to do so. It was a Ku Klux Klan, KKK, rally of about 1,000 people. The rally was held as a demonstration against the assault on the native-born Protestant Americans by the Roman Catholic Police of New York City. It was unclear whether Trump was an innocent onlooker, was arrested due to mistaken identity, or was really a participant of the rally. It was later on reported that he was released without any charges. While answering a press concern in 2015, Donald Trump said that his dad had actually not been jailed, and that he had never been a member of the KKK. Fred Trump's business built barracks and houses for the U.S. Navy officers during World War II. These were constructed near shipyards of various places, consisting of Newport News, Pennsylvania, Chester, and Norfolk, all along the East Coast. He constructed more than 2,000 middle-income group apartments for war veterans and their families. He built Shore Haven in Bensonhurst, in 1949, and Beach Haven near Coney Island, in 1950. He raised a housing complex of more than 3,000 apartment or condos called Trump Village in Coney Island, in between 1963 and 1964. The expense of this complex was approximated at $70 million. A U.S. Senate committee inspected Trump's company in 1954, for profiteering from public agreements and for overstating Beach Haven building charges. Trump and his partner, William Tomasello, were charged for acquiring loans totaling up to $3.5 million more than the house expense. During federal examinations, it was found that Trump had collected $1.7 million in excess, as lease, prior to beginning to pay his inexpensive federal government loan. Real estate designers typically paid bureaucrats to authorize their documents. Apart from collecting the extra rent, Trump had actually paid a generous architect fee to himself. The approximated building and construction expenses that he had shown were much more than the real quantity he had actually spent. However, everything was legal on the documents. He utilized his political contacts to gain access to federal government programs such as subsidized funding for apartment building developers. He admitted his controls of the federal government program before the U.S. Senate committee that investigated the housing abuse. Nevertheless, he believed there was nothing incorrect with what he had done, as whatever was done within legal borders. He, in truth, grumbled that the investigating committee had actually triggered damage to his track record. Other builders declined to answer, but he publicly took a self-justifying stand. Trump developed large apartment building and row houses around Sheepshead Bay, Flatbush, Coney Island, Brighton Beach, and Bensonhurst in Brooklyn, and Flushing and Jamaica Estates in Queens. He maintained the ownership, and the apartment or condos were provided on cost-effective rent. His building and constructions were marked with durable brick towers, with cool and nice parks around them. Donald Trump signed up with Trump Management in 1968, and in 1980, he changed the name to the Trump Organization. During the mid-1970s, he took a loan of $1 million from his daddy to begin his own real estate business in Manhattan. Supposedly, there were a variety of loans, which amounted to a lot more than what was specified. Fred Trump was typically compared to cars and truck magnate Henry Ford. He disliked borrowing money and was extremely prudent by nature. It is stated that he would check out the building and construction sites after a day's work and gather the nails that he discovered lying around. He would then hand them over to the carpenters the following day. For rather some time, he did not have an office and run from house. He did all his accounting in a small wallet. Around 1940, he got a little location as his office. Amy Lewerson worked as his secretary for 59 years. There were charges of racial discrimination versus his real estate company. Apparently, possible occupants of African-American descent were rejected houses in the complexes. In 1973, a case was filed by the Civil Rights Division of the U.S. Department of Justice against the Trump Organization for breaching the Fair Housing Act of 1968. The case continued for 2 years. An authorization decree was signed on June 10, 1975, between the Department of Justice and the Trump Organization, and it forbade the company from discriminating against individuals while selling or leasing an apartment or condo. Folk artist Woody Guthrie was among the occupants at Trump's apartment building in Brooklyn, in 1950. He composed a tune that plainly recommended that African-American people were not welcome as occupants in Trump's housing complexes. Throughout the post-World War II years, Trump claimed to be of Swedish descent and concealed his German origins. Those were the peak years of his profession. As a number of his occupants were Jewish, he hesitated that the German family tree would injure the business. Personal life. Trump wed Marianne McLeod in January 1936. They resided in Jamaica, Queens, and had 5 kids, Marianne Trump Berry, born 1937, who later ended up being a federal appeals court judge, Frederick Christ Trump Jr., born 1938, who later on ended up being an airline company pilot, Elizabeth Trump Grau, born 1942, a Chase Manhattan Bank executive, Donald Trump, born 1946, the 45th President of the United States, and Robert Trump, born 1948, President of Trump Management. Frederick Trump Jr. died in 1981, following alcoholism-related issues. Trump supported numerous charity homes, consisting of numerous Jewish and Israeli institutions, the Salvation Army, the Boy Scouts of America, and the Kew Forest School, where his children studied. He contributed buildings to organizations such as the Jamaica Hospital Medical Center, the National Kidney Foundation, the Cerebral Palsy Foundation, and the Community Mainstreaming Associates of Great Neck. Trump struggled with Alzheimer's disease for the last 6 years of his life. In June 1999, he fell ill with pneumonia and was admitted to the Long Island Jewish Medical Center. He passed away on June 25, 1999, at the age of 93.